He's deciding whether or not he wants. Okay, yeah, he wants to play last. Yeah, we're not gonna mulligan a hand with skin renderer. So, we'll see where it goes. Our start isn't as aggressive without the Glenhawk, but we've got some nice 4-drops, so we'll, we should be able to do some stuff. Let's see how he ends up playing out. His draw this turn isn't. His draw this game, yeah, probably won't be as slow because the draw last game was really slow. And it's hard to have a draw that's comparable to that. Bladed Pinions doesn't do anything. So we're just going to start dropping 4-drops. He probably won't play. Oh, nothing. Alright, well, that makes it a lot easier. We'll just bash and play more 4-drops. Let's see. The best. We could play Aggressive Slasher to play, but that plays into Virulent Wound. I mean, that puts him on a 3-turn clock, but it's likely that whatever he plays next turn, since he missed a land drop, he's probably not going to have that much time to come back, which means that playing a 3-power creature as opposed to a 4-power creature won't. It won't cost us much. Yeah, he's just got nothing, so we'll go ahead and bash with both and then play a 4-1. And I mean, our other option is to pump and play Mirrorsmith, which is, I mean, that's okay, but it's more likely that we're going to play Skinrender next turn, and either plays into Virulent Wound, but the Rusted Slasher kills him a turn. It kills him more quickly. At this point, I mean, he either has Virulent Wound or he doesn't. Both options are bad against it, so we'll just play the one that rewards us for not having it. Here we got Phyrexian Rager, and yeah, that's gonna get skin rendered because it just gives us so much tempo. Even though it's not really the best creature to kill. And yeah, this wasn't really much of a game. But that's the way it goes. We have the option of playing our Glinthawk on this turn just to make it harder for him to block, but I mean, all of our creatures are lethal except for the Auric Replica, and he's only on 3 mana, so I mean, it doesn't really do anything except to help Mirrorsmith, so we'll just go ahead and pass. And he's probably going to concede here. And there you have it. Well, first round's done, so I think we got pretty lucky this game because his draw was so bad, but his deck didn't appear to be very good, so we'll take it though and see how the next round goes.